Hey guys, welcome to another episode in my Arsenal career mode. Although there's no Arsenal in this episode, it is entirely about Belgium. As you know, I took up the offer to manage Belgium. An international offer is always something I decline, but I felt like Belgium could be a great team. And our first game in the World Cup, yes, that's right, this is the World Cup, is against Korea Republic. But anyway, if you're wondering why it sounds very different in this video, one, I'm still recovering from my cold, and two, I'm actually using my brother's headset. I'm in my old house, and I'm attempting to make a video on my shitty laptop, which I finally actually finished editing an episode to do the voiceover. By the way, here you can see me putting the team together if you're interested who I selected. But yeah, my laptop crashed 3 times during the edit process, so normally I can probably edit a video into a career mode episode in about 30 minutes, I would say. I've been, well, an hour and a half. It's just been insane. But hopefully, touch wood, I'm on the desk, and this will not crash during the recording. But anyway, you can see the team there. We've gone with a 3-5-2 just purely because the defenders suit that so well. And up front, it means we can play the beasts, Benteke and Lukaku, together. I mean, who do you select if you can only have one? I think Benteke, for me, is just that slightly better player in this game than Lukaku. A bit more agile, I think Benteke is. Lukaku feels a little bit more sluggish on the ball, I guess. But yeah, that's just how I feel. But I want you guys to leave comments below. There's two questions I've got, really. Who do you prefer in FIFA, Benteke or Lukaku? Or who would you rather play with in FIFA? But who do you think is going to be the best player in real life in the next 5 years, Lukaku or Benteke? I'm going to go ahead and say Lukaku. I think if he still improves during his Everton loan, I think when he goes back to Chelsea and he gets some game time there, he could become a huge, huge striker in this world of football. I think Benteke the same, just not at Villa. I think he will have to move on at some point. But anyway, unfortunately, guys, because of all the issues I've been having, I've only been able to get one match so far, so I do plan on doing more today. Hopefully I will have another episode up tonight, probably tomorrow, now that my laptop's been crashing loads. And what a way to start this match against Korea, of which, by the way, I'm playing on Legendary. Yes, that's right. I thought, there's not really a better time to try it out when it's non-Arsenal matches. So if I was going to go up to Legendary, it was this match. So the World Cup, I will be playing on Legendary, just so you guys know. And like I said there, we have started so well against Korea here. Benteke scoring a great goal, assisted by the young beast, Bakali, who is playing out on the right wing. We've got Hazard on the left. I mean, that is so dangerous. And Bakali is absolutely amazing. Or is it Bakali? But either way, very, very decent players. And this is what you get with Legendary. They're very difficult to tackle. They change and switch directions so quickly. And this, like, what the fuck just happened? I'm going to have to get you a replay, because when you score goals like that, EA have purposely made the game skip the replays. Of course, you're unable to watch them. It completely skipped the replay. So I went in and got the footage just for you here, guys. It is ridiculous what happens here. Just take a look at this. Right, fair enough. It's shoddy defending, but I can clear this, right? Fuck off. Just fuck off, goalkeeper. Courtois, what are you actually doing? It doesn't make sense. I can't blame Vermaelen. I just cannot. Or was it Vertonghen? I think it was actually Vermaelen there. It was a great block, right? All you need him to do is smash it out. And what does the goalkeeper do? He jumps in front of the clearance. It's just such a clever idea. And then towards the end of the first half there, almost broke through a very strong Korean defence, especially in Legendary. It's so, so difficult. And that meant we go in at half-time at 1-0. But I was definitely the better team. And actually, I've got to say, I was pretty proud of that. You know, Legendary is not easy to play at all, and I've done okay. 1-0 at half-time is it's pretty flattering to Korea. They didn't really have many chances, as you saw there. But, you know, they got a bit of luck there, and we obviously got a bit of unluckiness. but either way, my luck continued in the second half. I was playing pretty dodgy there. You saw the strayed pass there. It was awful. It gives it away. And luckily, they fluff up the chance there to score, because that would have been an awful time to concede. And then Park comes on, the legend, actually getting a game. So we're hopefully going to win this game, because the start of the World Cup is very important to get a nice 3 points in the table, because there's not many games. There just isn't enough time to really get your points in early, so it's really important. And Benteke almost scored an absolute duplicate of the goal he scored in the first half here. Cross from the wing, but this time he goes with his head. And unfortunately, it was not on target. They get themselves a free kick as well here, which was so close. On world class, he would have skied it, no doubt in my mind. But on Legendary, they do get more, you know, corners, more free kicks and penalties on target, I would say, because obviously they are harder to play against. Either way, though, in the last few minutes, guys, I brought on a few players, Fellaini, De Bruyne, any players that would give me a bit of boost in fitness, and I went for De Bruyne, playing in that cam role, and boy, did he make an impact straight away, pretty much. Scores an absolute beauty. It comes off the defender, but was it already going in? Let's take a look at the replay here. I think, personally, that was going in. I don't think the keeper was going to reach it. So let me know in the comments what you think. But what a gem of a goal. And the timing could not be better. But, guys, this is FIFA. You probably know what's going to happen. You'll notice there isn't a cut here. I've kind of given it away. But this is what FIFA is about. And when, I know I've mentioned it a lot, when you're playing on Legendary, you have to be focused. Okay, you need to be on the ball the whole time. And their second goal is just as shit as their first. It's a lovely pass, don't get me wrong. But watch Courtois here. I think I might have to drop him. I mean, what? I might have to play Mignolet instead. Look at this. He does a freaking dolphin dive after the ball has gone past. I don't get it. Is it over yet? Are they going to score a last-minute winner? Or am I going to score a last-minute winner? You just don't know in FIFA. The 90th minute can last 10 minutes in real life. Slight exaggeration, but you know what I mean. And I really genuinely thought, fuck, this can't happen. Not in the first game against, I don't want to be mean, but a pretty weak side compared to the rest of the group, which is Cameroon and Turkey, I believe. Are we going to hold on? Please get at least the point after that. And thankfully the referee blows his whistle. So unfortunately, guys, I'm sorry for a slightly shorter video. I'll try my best to get one out tomorrow. The internet is being fixed on Wednesday, apparently. The engineer's coming out, so that should be good. But yeah, it's looking okay. I will definitely stick on Legendary, and hopefully I will win the next few games. And hopefully we might just get into the World Cup final. Obviously, I'll be returning to the Arsenal career mode as soon as the internet's back up and I can do the awards video. But for now, guys, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.